Right, let's bring in Mansour Shuman. He's from Gaza and has lived through the war in Rafah and Khan Yunis. Mansour is now in Turkey and he joins us from Istanbul. Thank you for joining us. So, the United Nations has been calling the conflict a cycle of displacement, survival and despair. You know that all too well, having left Gaza. Yet the US President Joe Biden has claimed to have put together a peace plan for the Middle East that, according to his words, may be coming to fruition. Is there any sign Biden's words may be true?
The sources close to the Palestinian negotiation team are telling us that they have become more lenient on some of the points that were stopping the negotiations from advancing. And right now, the Palestinian people inside of Gaza and outside are feeling a bit more optimistic, given what President Biden has said, in addition to some of the some of the talks that have been leaked out, talking about how some parts of the negotiations have advanced properly. However, nothing concrete has still come out, but things are much more optimistic than they were earlier, definitely, a few weeks from now.
So, an optimistic mood, you suggest, but where exactly are we right now on the revived ceasefire for captives proposal, namely that negotiations on the release of Israeli captives in Gaza, including soldiers, will begin 16 days after the first phase of talks?
My understanding is that they've become a little bit more lenient on several parts of the negotiations, including even allowing soldiers who were taken captured in October the 7th. But in response to that, there needs to be a long-term ceasefire with an attention to ensuring that no more fighting happens, that the troops leave Gaza Strip as soon as possible. In addition to that, opening all borders as before. So there has been a leniency better than before, and the Palestinian side continues to go into these negotiations under fire, under pressure, and trying to get the best for the Palestinian people. This is my understanding moving forward.
Right. And from the Israeli perspective, I suppose they need to feel that there is an off-ramp in negotiations for them as well. However, Israel says gaps still remain with Hamas over talks with the group. I mean, what do we understand these gaps to be?
Again, I don't know the details, but definitely killing five more journalists over the last 12 hours won't help. Definitely the incursions that are happening in Shuja'iyah and Khan Yunis and Rafah definitely will not help. Netanyahu is still a big roadblock, and we need the people inside of Israel to continue to put pressure on Netanyahu and his government to put an end to this genocide attempt. He is the biggest roadblock right now in order to achieve peace in the Middle East and in Gaza.
All right. Mansour Shuman, good to hear your thoughts. Many thanks for joining us.
Thank you.